I got another thrift store find for $14. It looks like a component for a microsystem. It doesn't have a model number on it, but when I did do a search, I ended up coming up with this DVD Micro Theater. And that's pretty much it right there. The only thing it's missing is there is a plate that was on here. I just finished scraping off the glue. As you can see, there's scrape marks. But it was just bare glue, and this thing was like filthy. Anyway, I'm pretty sure the top component was still there. I didn't bother picking it up only because it didn't have the speakers. If it had the speakers and it was complete, I definitely would have picked it up for a little bit more than what I paid, obviously. But yeah, at least I got the model number. It's MCD908-98. And it's got, they're saying here, it's basically just a tube buffer. And if you go to details about the product, here we go. It's 2x75 watts RMS, vacuum tube preamp, class D digital amplifier, and yeah, I didn't have any other components, but we're going to see what's inside of it. I basically bought it for parts. I love the wood grain that's on the side of it, if I can show you that. Isn't that beautiful? I cleaned it up. It was so filthy you couldn't see it. But that alone, I could take that off and make an amp out of that. All right, this side here, there was just a small little chip on this side. It's not major. Here's the back. It's all metal. Decent binding posts. So yeah, it's really heavy, so I'm dying to see what's inside this thing. I already plugged it in, and it obviously doesn't power up because you need the other part of the component. But it wouldn't be my first one that I've hacked, so we're going to dig into it and see if we can get it to power up, even function maybe as an amplifier, which would be sweet. Look at that grain. Oh, beautiful. Get a lot of the filth off. Cleaned up the front. Like I said, there's a plate that's supposed to cover the tubes that's missing. Couple of light scratches there, nothing major. The sides turned out really nice. Look at that. Nice wood grain. But this thing is heavy, so I'm kind of curious to see what's inside of it. Even the back is metal. Now, I looked up the specs. I don't know if I ever mentioned it or not. It's a Class D amp, basically. So I would like to actually try and get it to work. I would use it as an amp. As a block amp. And why does that one keep turning? Is there even a screw in there? Give me a minute. Are you seeing this? If that's what I think it is, I think I've already got my $14 back. You know the price of Toleroid transformers, because that's what it looks like. And a big one at that. That's what the weight is. So this has got a half decent amp in it, which I'm very happy about. Let's get this thing open. Sweet! And this is a half-decent preamp, too, to boot. I thought I would just be really super cheap on the preamp section, but that looks pretty good, actually. This looks like here, it's just basically power supply for the component that I would be powering up, being like the receiver or whatever. We got a few bulgy caps here on the digital amp, which could be a problem. Might be the reason why I was in thrift. But there is a relay to power it up. So, would have to plug it in and test this transformer. Or is that a choke? That's a choke. It is a choke. the wires that come across here, go over to here, go over to here, and go to there. Guaranteed, if we were to bridge, we'll test these wires, see if we can just bridge it here and activate the relay, or if it's a 5 volt or 12 volt, we'll figure it out. But once we get this activated, this would power it up, including the amp. But I'm gonna probably replace those caps before I even power it up. And then we also have to figure out where's the output. I mean the input, right? We'll have to figure that out. I'm guessing it'll be in this jack here, and we'll have to pin it out. It's doable. We'll pull the fuses out and look at those two. Yeah, number one priority is just getting it to turn on. Once it turns on, we can put some speakers on it, poke around, see if we can find the input. Which probably won't be easy because it's a digital amp. We'll figure it out. Anyway, let's see what we got here. Where's it go? Goes over here. Plugs in right there. Don't know if it has any writing on it. Let's take a look at it. Yeah, that's definitely our wire. One pin says VCC. The other one says ECO. And the bottom one is ground. So. And that would go through these pins right here to the other component that would plug into this to hit the turn the relay on, which would turn transformer on and then give us power. Or is it the other way around? No, that's the output. Is it? No? Yes? I love that transformer, though. Hee-hee! Maybe I can't get this to work. That's more than worth the $14 I paid for it. Just trying to follow the wires to the plug. Where they go. Oh, okay. Can you see that? There actually is leads going in to power that up. And that transformer is a input red is 120 volts and blue is 10 vac 1 amp. Okay, so that does power the board that hits the relay. So this really is, this plug here really is, I guarantee you, if we just short these two wires together, they'll flick that on and then we'll have power. Could be wrong. Let's find out. What's the worst that could happen? A little bit of a connector rut. All right, where's the cord? So like I said, my theory is when you plug this into the other component controls the on and off through that relay, which turns this piece on, which we're about to find out. There's no external fuse, it's just the two that are in there. Actually, let's quickly pull them out and just have a quick look at them, just to make sure they aren't popped. That'll just leave us wondering what the hell's the matter with it. One's good. Okay, so the fuses are good. We got that out of the way. I said I don't really want to power it up without replacing those caps. I don't want to damage that amp. I don't want to use it. But I'm just going to quickly try it, see if my theory is correct. Whoop. I got power. Well, it's turning on anyway that way. Let's see if we get the tubes to light up. We'll see how we're going to do this. Maybe I can just short the pins together. I definitely know it's a transformer because I can see the lights flickering. Okay, that's not going to work. Let's open the bin them. Didn't work. Let's put an alligator clip on it and be done with it. Okay, we are powered up. Do we have any tube action? I don't know how much these are going to light up, if any. I'm not seeing anything yet. No filaments. Oh, wait. We got a power switch here. Oh, that's a source switch. Well, it's not looking good. Theory-wise, I thought these would just light up and then power on. I'll put a set of junky speakers on it, see if we get any output. Well, that sucks. The tubes, I'll probably have to find a PDF for this system, but there's no markings on the tubes whatsoever. They're made sure nobody could replace them. Makes you wonder if they're even still good. Anyway, I'm still trying. I got the back end to power on, including the digital amp. I still haven't figured out how to get this to power up, because it wouldn't be just the tubes. There's LEDs and all kinds of stupid things in here that would light this area up, and I'm not detecting anything. So I'm going to put the tubes back in and start poking around on the board, see what we can find. These things were hard to get out. I was yanking on them like crazy. Looking at that, you would think that maybe that was like a 12 volt preamp, tube amp. Doesn't look very intimidating, does it? You think it's coming off the transformer, it's a lower voltage, it's not. It says right on there, caution, live. What does it say? Live earth. And I went and tested the leads off of the I tested the leads. It comes up to 117 volts. So that would have been bad poking around in there. Those caps there are rated for, doesn't say. Turn on the side. Does not say on this side either. There it is. 350 volts at 100 UF. So yeah, I mean, that is actually good. I mean, this is a legitimate tube preamp. It's not some random cheap buffer that's in the signal path. It's actually a tube preamp with legitimate rail voltage, which means plate voltage. So probably 100 volts a plate, 110 volts a plate, 130 maybe. Is it 160? I don't remember how much the plate voltage is for preamps. I'm guessing it may be 120. Anyway, it's a legitimate plate voltage, so that means this front end's going to sound pretty good. I just have to figure out how to activate it. Now we're getting power to the board. And I've tested off the caps. We got a regulator over here and this ribbon cable. It would be sweet if I could just jumper a pin and it works, but nothing's that easy. I'm gonna keep poking around until I find something that makes the lights come on, basically. Like, we already know we got that one jumper, as soon as you plug it in, it powers the transformer on. So let me poke around, and when I find something, I'll let you know what I find. Poking around, I just want to make sure the high side of the board is good. We're testing right off a capacitor, 240 volts, which is sweet. So that means the high side is good. It's the low side in the regulator that we have to get the turn on. Still working on it. Oh, the Class D amp is actually powered on. It's ejecting a little bit of heat, which is good. That means it's working. And there's a legend on the board right here that shows us what the pinout is and what the inputs are. And the two first wires there are the inputs. So we're going to follow that, and we could probably put some RCAs on this and use it as an amp. We can get the front to work, which I'm still working on. The reason I tested that at the capacitor is because there's a rectifiers here, and it's got some bad solder on some of them. And I wanted to make sure that these were all working. So the issue is over here and down here. I do love grabbing stuff that other people have had problems with. Look at these rectifiers. They look a little charcoal-y. Look at the nice soldering job underneath. And the last pin there is totally broken. So we'll try, I don't know, re-soldering that last pin and hope for the best. But at least this has a legend on it, so this is getting me closer to getting the front to power up. But have a problem. I'm just guessing, but I'm gonna say that this is the issue right here. Yeah. We'll reflow the solder and fix the cracked solder there, and we'll test this rectifier too to make sure it's working properly. Okay, it's been a fun ride through hell, but I managed to get it to power up a little bit, as you can see. The issue is, the regulator wouldn't fire off, obviously, because it's missing the other half of the unit. So I basically used a yellow wire and bridged it right to the socket, or the socket of the tube, which the lights, the LEDs are tied into. As you can see, the filaments are lit up as well as the LEDs. It's kind of weird how they light up too, because watch this. Turn it off. And as soon as you plug it in, now it's on. It slowly warms up. Kind of weird. Maybe it's designed like that, I guess. Let's give it that glow look. Anyway, this one here, this is the lead that's left and right in and left and right out. I'm not too sure about this amp. I think this amp might be seen better days. Not that I'm going to lose sleep over it. If I can get the pre to work with the lights, the sides lit up, I will just disable this stuff here. Remove these connectors for another project, and basically put RCAs in here just so I can use this pre, like the one I have upstairs already, but I'll use this instead. I'm pretty sure it'll work. The high voltages are here, the real voltages are there, and the filaments are lit up, so it should work in theory. I'm going to test that theory by pinning out the, it's right, there's a legend on the board there. I'm going to pin this out and give it an input and output and see what I get. Alright, so to see if we re-erected the tube section, got that working at least before we dig into that, because like I said, there's a lot of bag caps on that and it's probably already fried. I went ahead and set up some RCAs just to quickly test P2P.
The way this is set up is black and yellow is out.
That'd be these two. Black and yellow, that's out.
And red and white is in.
So that's these two here. So we'll try it out, see what happens. See if I'll take it upstairs and plug it in. Hopefully, it doesn't blow up anything on my system. Probably won't. It's probably just a buffer, but we'll find out. Well, this will be part one of what we're going to do with this. It does work. But it's got a little bit of a hum to it. Can you hear that? Yeah, on both sides. Now, the 18 or 20 volt rail off of this wire here, it actually comes in at double 12 volts. It goes through this capacitor here that's bulging and hot. So I'm guessing it's dead. And basically, that's why we're getting the hum. I bet you when I replace that cap, the hum will go with it. But it does work as a preamp. So that's cool. There's a number of ways we can go about this. I say screw the Class D amp because it's probably no good anyway. Get all that stuff out of there, including the transformer, and put in a 12-volt transformer just for the filaments. Oh, wait, no, I can't do that because it's got the high side on this. So you pretty much would need this transformer regardless because you got 180-volt rails going into the preamp stage. Yeah. So this will have to stay. That's still not bad. If we can get rid of that hum, this would work. And then we can get all this crap out of here and call it a day. But it does work. All right, so what to do next? Well, I'm going to take it downstairs and swap that tube out. I mean, that cap out and see if it gets rid of the hum before we go to part two. Yeah, that's the only one I can see that... that's the only one that filters that whole rail. That's a 12-volt or 18-volt rail. Is that one right there. And as you can see, she is puffy and she has... It has drained or popped because you can see a little bit of brown goop on the end there. So if that's the only thing that's filtering the filaments up the tubes, you will get a little bit of hum through that as well as the plate. If these were bad here, these are the high side on the plate, you would get hum. But just that little bit of hum is just from the filaments. So I bet you as soon as we replace this, it's going to make a big difference. Geez, I thought that was all glue underneath. That's actually electrolyte that's dried up. That's all from the tube. I mean, the cap. So yeah, I'd say it's done. So we have a legend on the board, so when I pull it off, I know the polarity. Yep. Okay. I want to try and find, since it is a single cap that's doing all that, I want to try and find one that's the biggest one I can find, basically. The bigger the cap, the better. Oh, she's old. She's very old. Now what's the voltage on this? 25 volts at 2200 UF. Well, let me look around and see what I got. If I have to use something used, I will. At least if it's not leaking, it's going to work, right? I didn't have the exact value, so what I did is I just basically stacked two just to make up the value to 1,000 watt or 1,000 UF. This is 2,200. It's close enough. There's going to be some capacity there. We'll see how long they last before they go off like a jet engine. I really feel sorry for the people that own this amplifier and had to put up with that humming for God knows how long, because now it's dead silent. sounds good too. Even if I turn these all the way up, dead silent. So it was definitely was the capacitors. So what I'm going to do now is let it sit for a while and marinate and see how hot they get. If they do, then I'll set a capacitor with some leads in the case and then run them to the board. Something then I can pretty much use any capacity I want. But it is working. Cool. I'll see you in part 3. We'll figure out what the hell we're going to do with it. Later, guys. Part 2. Later.